Hello and welcome to this short instruction to Motion Studio Constraint. MSC, Motion Studio Constraint, is a plugin created by me. My name is Design Devil, and here I want to show you how you can use it. After installing MSC, you get this little icon here, and if you click on it, the Motion Studio Constraints window appears. So, what is Motion Studio Constraints? Motion Studio Constraints, as the name said, gives you the ability to create or to constrain any object that you want with a joint from Motion Studio. The best way is I show you what I mean. So let's create a new skeleton with two bones and bring it a bit in position. Really quick and dirty. And let's say we create another skeleton as subskeleton of the first one. Maybe it could be the arm of the character or anything like this. Create also another bone. Let's show all. And we also set up a position for this a bit. Okay, now let's choose the first skeleton and this joint here and connect the skeleton to this bone as a subskeleton. Okay, so as you can see now, if you want to animate such a structure of skeletons, it is sometimes difficult to select directly the joint. Also, if you switch the auto drill down select option on, sometimes it is nearly impossible. As you can see here, I just select the skeleton. So I have always to go through the list of bones, and if I want to get access to the subskeleton, I also have to choose the skeleton first and then switch to the right bone and so on. And this is not a good workflow. So let's see what the MSC can do for us. I bring this window here a bit out of the view so that we have much space here to show something. I've prepared in my object library a lot of objects here. So let's import a few ones here. Maybe this one and this one and this one. Okay. Now that's enough. These are normal polyhedron objects, quite simple made arrows here. I created here two arrows and created a union object because I can see it good in top view or a side view. That's the only reason. Okay, now I have three objects here. And now let's bring this object into position. I want this object here to control this joint. So I bring it in the position nearly to this joint. That's okay. And now let's say we want to control this joint here from the main skeleton with this object here. So let's bring this also in position, but we leave this arrow here, this control object, a bit in front of the skeleton. Okay, out of the way. Let's open the Motion Studio Constraints window. And now I have selected this object here, and I click on the Get button for the controller, and the name appears here. Now I select the joint that I want to control, and I click in the joint here on the Get button. Now I can choose if these controller objects here are be visible at render time. If not, I leave the default. At last, I click on Apply. I can now see that the buttons here are inactive. That means my constraint is working. If I now drag the object here, you can see the joint will follow. Also, if I drag the joint around, this object will follow. Let's do the same thing for the other one. Again, I click on the Get button, and now I choose in Motion Studio. You cannot see it. I have selected now the other joint, and click again here on Joint. Click also and Apply, and also for this object here. Maybe in wireframe it is a bit faster. It's a bit slow here because I record the video. But what you can see now is I just have to select the object and automatically the right skeleton is selected and I can move my joints around. These objects here controls just the position, just movement. If I rotate this around, it rotates the object, but rotating a joint has no effect over the animation. Okay, you can also change the option here, controller visible at render time. Every time you click a controller object, the informations here are redrawn, or you can see here the correct constraint, and you can click a new option here. Again, click on Apply, and if you now select, you see always the actual information here. Let's see what's happened if we render this scene. You can see now that this object here is visible at render time. I switch it off, render again, and you can see it, the objects are invisible at render time. You also can delete a single constraint. Select the constraint that you want to delete. Click on Delete Constraint, and now just this object here is a constraint. This object here is just the object as before. You can also delete all, very easy. And now you could start again. And you can also, let's do this again here, apply. Get this, apply. Whoops, one of these objects is already constrained. Okay, it's good enough. Let's say you want to save these constraints that you have created. You can click on the Save button, a normal Save As Under dialog appears, and you can choose a file name here and save this. After reloading a scene, you can, if you load a scene, the constraint are not active, it's just a normal scene. You have to reload your constraints, and then you have your constraints back as before. Okay, that's all. I hope you find it useful, and if you have problems with that, feel free to contact me through my website www.designdevil.de, or on the forum, in the German forum or in the international forum. So, have a good time. See you next. Bye bye.